by Pics, KJU working on nuke delivery system that won't require ICBMs. North Korea working on submarine nuke launches. Tis no secret that North Korea has been building and testing long-range missiles, with the intent to deliver nuclear warheads to targets as far away as the United States. While the nuclear capabilities of dictator Kim Jong-un's regime have advanced dramatically, many observers believed it would be some time before a Pyongyang missile would be a real threat to the U.S. However, new spy photographs reveal that the rogue nation has been working on an alternative way to deliver weapons of mass destruction. And it doesn't require advanced, long-range ICBM technology. Commercial satellite imagery of the Sinpo South shipyard from November 5 indicates that North Korea is on an aggressive schedule to build and deploy its first operational ballistic missile submarine, revealed 38 North. The group known as 38 North is an academic think tank of Korean experts at the Johns Hopkins School of Advanced International Studies. An analysis of the satellite photos suggests that the reclusive country is taking its submarine technology seriously, and working feverishly to ready the undersea weapons for a potential provocation. Throughout 2017, there has been continued movement of parts and components into and out of the two parts yards adjacent to the construction halls in the center of the shipyard, 38 North reported. Accompanying this has been the movement of the gantry and tower cranes that service the yards, the foreign policy group continued. Included photographs from the group were labeled with detailed indications that submarine overhauls were underway. A craft is most lethal when it has submarine-launched ballistic missile, SLBM, capabilities. And the satellite photos show that this is exactly what North Korea is developing. At the test stand, imagery from November 5 shows an object visible at the top of the service tower that appears to be either a launch canister support or launch canister, explained the think tank. The continued presence of this object suggests ongoing SLBM ejection tests. If correct, this is likely a continuation of the ejection test campaign reported during July of this year. Outgoing ejection testing means that the regime is perfecting its ability to deploy SLBMs from underwater. Those submarine-launched missiles then seek out a target and deliver a deadly warhead at fairly close range. It would be tempting to dismiss any North Korean sub-developments as laughable and incompetent. However, the country's rapid advances in nuclear and ballistic missile technology should serve as a warning: don't underestimate the regime. No, North Korea won't be landing a man on the moon anytime soon, but all that it takes is one nuclear warhead to reach its target, and thousands of lives along with global stability could be threatened. Advances in submarine capability could move the goalposts, so to speak, and enable the Kim regime to launch a strike against a Western country from a point fairly close to the target. The closer a sub can get to its objective, the less perfect a missile needs to be in order to be devastatingly effective. Nations such as the United States and Russia have perfected nuclear-powered submarines, but North Korea may not need to emulate this level of ability in order to be a threat. While somewhat outdated, a diesel-electric submarine such as the Korean Sinpo class is still able to be rather stealthy when operating on battery power. That reality is something the United States must take a long, hard look at. Complacency is dangerous, and it's time to take the growing threat from North Korea seriously.